Okay. Sparkman just told me, hit the subscribe button. So I just did. So stop whining. Eat your sandwich.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman and today we're going to create a pendulum. Okay, so let me show you the demo. Don't worry, there is no math involved. Well, a little bit. Okay, so let's open the example file, which you are going to find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There is a link to the paid version, which allows you to make commercial games. Alright, so let's go over the assets. See that this is just a background. You don't actually need it, but we're gonna leave it there. Here is our cuckoo clock. Move the clock out of the way. And here is our medallion. Is that how you spell medallion? Google it, my friend. Every time you don't know something, you're supposed to Google medallion. Yes, I spelled it right. Now you can see that the clock is a static object and it's just a picture. And this also is a static object. Put it back in place. Actually, let me move the clock out of the way for now. I have a counter here on the screen and here is an active object, which we are going to use later. So if you run the frame, you'll notice that nothing happens. Okay, let's go to the event editor. Let's create an always add 4 to this counter. Throw it out. That works fine. Under the medallion, let's go to set angle. We're gonna use scene for this. A little bit of math here, not too much. And inside scene, we're going to set this to the counter. And we're gonna multiply this by 42. Set the quality to 1. Throw it out. And you can see that that works fine. Now, if we set the counter to 1, you notice that it moves a lot slower. 3. It's a bit more like what we're looking for. Let's place this here. And here is our clock. Move this counter out of the way. Or you can just make it invisible if you wanted to. Now, you can do collisions with this if you wanted to. Let's go to the event editor. And if our medallion is not overlapping this object, change the direction to right. And copy line 2. Paste it. Negate it. And in this case, we're going to set this to the opposite direction. So if you double click on the object, you can see that we have two directions. Two different animations. Place this over here. And you can see that the collisions work perfect. Okay, so that's it for this video. You can see that this has many practical applications. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out my other channel, Sparkman Vlog. Subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next episode.